Hello, let's linearize some data. All right, I'm going to show you in this video just kind of how to set up a linearization in Logger Pro and present it in your report. This is not going to go over concepts of linearization, kind of how it works and why we do all this crazy stuff. I got another video floating out there, so check that out if you're trying to understand what we're doing and why. I'm just going to kind of show you really the buttons to press and how to make Logger Pro do it. Okay, so I've got some data here. I graphed some data. I did an experiment. And my data looks curvy. I think if I put a straight line on it, it's no bueno. That doesn't look very good to me. I don't think that represents what's going on here. But I don't want to put a linear fit on it. Okay, so here's what you do when your data is not linear. You only have one other option. You come up here to curve fit. And the only fit you ever pick other than linear, linear is great to pick if your data makes a straight line. If it doesn't, the only thing you do is you pick power, a power fit. All right, don't ever, ever, ever pick any of this nonsense. Don't do this. You'll be tempted. Don't be like, oh, quintic fit. Look at this. Oh my gosh, incredible. It fits all my data perfectly. This must be like the right thing to do. Look at that. No, it's like how a polynomial works. It's allowed to turn around and stuff. Logger Pro is just a connect the dots machine. Be careful. Think about what you're doing. If you say this, if you put this on your graph, you're saying you think nature works this way, that like displacement depends on some number times t plus something else times t squared plus something else times t cubed plus something else times t to the fourth, right? That's what you'd be saying. That's not a universe I want to live in. Physics is hard enough as it is and kind of amazing, but physics usually works out to something relatively simple like this. All right, so power fit. Only thing to ever do is power fit if it's not great. Power, power, power fit. If you're doing some fancy IA stuff, maybe you do something different, but definitely never want to. All right, but for our purposes, only ever linear or power. It's not a straight line, so I'm putting on a power fit. Look at that, looks great. Okay, the B number is the main number I'm gonna look at to decide how to linearize, but this looks pretty good. So you do wanna present this graph. Now that you've graphed your original data that you processed, you wanna show this because you're gonna have to talk about how you linearized and why, and this number on this graph is your justification for how you linear. So I want to just put this graph in a report as is. I don't do min-max lines on this because I don't have a slope to take an uncertainty of, and that's why we do min-max lines. So no other lines on a power fit. I just basically want to put this in the report, so I'm just going to clean it up a little bit. So I want to get these stupid brackets out of here because they always show up on the first and last points. So I'm zooming out to get them way out of the way. And then I'm going to do like a zoom box, so I'm going to click and drag and zoom into what I drag to. So I'm just making sure I can see the origin, you pass my last data point, highlight whatever you want and press zoom in, and I'll zoom into what you highlighted. All right, I'm pretty good now. I wanna copy paste this in, but remember if I copy paste it like this, it's gonna look bad and be almost unreadable. So what I wanna do is shrink it way down. You do this with every graph in Logger Pro when you put it in a report. Shrink it way down, I'm gonna move my text box so I can see everything, I can see the line. A fit, I can see the text box, I'll be able to read this stuff, I'm pretty sure. But let's make sure. I'm going to copy paste it into a document. All right, so I'm just Control C to copy, and I'm coming. I got a little lab report, somewhat started here. And look at this. Oh my gosh, look how beautiful, so readable, even too big, so much. I can just kind of do this, make it look good, make it so that I can know I'm definitely going to be able to see those numbers and stuff. I'll clean it up, center it. Do the border thing, but there we go. All right, so this is how you're gonna present when you linearize. You always show like the original process data that you did, and then you graph the data and you show your power fit, because then you're going to justify what you're doing. So I kind of started that already. You don't have to watch me type, but that's kind of an example of what you might say for something like this. Of course, yours will be different. Your data is gonna be different and every experiment's different. But for this one, I'm picking second power. And the thing you do always want to do is talk about the B number. Okay. Again, the main point of showing this even is because the B number is going to justify what you do. So I'm saying, Logger Pro said, gave a power fit with this number for B, 2.044 here. So I think that's good evidence that this is probably supposed to be a second power relationship. Because the number's close to two, that's a reasonable number to expect, like in a physics equation, that it depends on. A t squared makes a lot of sense to me. I maybe even did some research or know a little bit of physics and understand that it makes good physics sense to me why displacement should depend on t squared, right? So you're choosing something that's physically meaningful. I'm not going to do 2.044. That doesn't mean anything. I got to, you know, make an educated guess, and I think this one's pretty straightforward that it's got to be a 2. So what you do whenever you linearize is you take that B number, you take the number you kind of guess from the B number, and you do y versus x to the B. That's really what it always is. You raise your x values to this power, but not exactly this number, right? Again, the number you pick. So I'm not going to raise them to 2.044. That would be silliness, but I'll raise them to 2. I'll square them because I think that's like what the relationship really kind of is that I'm. All right, so you got to square all your times, and you got to plot. In this case, I got to plot displacement versus time squared. You got to b power all your x's and plot y versus x to the b. That's what we're always doing when we. All right, so I did it in Excel. You're gonna have some fun in Excel. Here you go. There's my original data, and then made another table. Yet another table because now I got to take my times and square them for this example. So you know, I really just. Took my numbers for t and squared them. I just told Excel, hey, take those times, square them. I do want to make sure I'm adjusting all of my stuff, like my names of my headers and the units and the name of the table title. And I even got to propagate error. I got to do all the, you know, uncertainty stuff because uncertainty is fun and I'm squaring numbers that have uncertainty. This example, right? So you will almost definitely have to propagate error. All right. So then you would show this table because this is what's going to come on the next graph because I'm going to show two graphs, my power fit graph and then my linearized. All right, so I put this table into the report. You know, I would want to kind of clean it up and make it look nice, but get to the graph. So this is the stuff I want to graph, and I got to graph it on Logger Pro. So let's do that. All right, this is really similar to, you know, when you're doing different size error bars and stuff. But you're just going to add a couple new columns. You probably need two. You need one for like x to the b, the new thing you're going to put on x. And you maybe need another one for the uncertainty of that number. Kind of depends on your uncertainty word. For mine, I definitely do. So I'm going to go to up here to data. I'm going to data. I'm going to new manual column. New manual. And so I'm going to put those linearized numbers in here, which for this one were times squared. And I'm going to label them real clear, like, so I'm going to use like the little superscript options here. So I'm doing T. So if you're doing the power stuff, click the little drop down. It gives you all these options. I go to superscript and I'll do 2. So it'll make it squared. So, you know, time squared, I'll call it T squared. It does have units of seconds squared now, right? If I square a number, the units are squared too. Okay. There we go. So that's my first new column, time squared. And then I'm going to make another new column because I know these numbers all have different uncertainties. So I'll do it all. I'm going to go to data, new manual column. Okay, this one is, you know, kind of, I can be sloppy with this one because this doesn't show up anywhere on your graph. You know, this is just like the header that you'll see here so you know what you're looking at. So I will do this so I know what I'm doing. I'm going to put delta t squared. What it is, it's the uncertainty in t squared, and I'll just say done because I'm going to tell Logger Pro to use these numbers for error bars. Okay, so let's look at my data. I really just want to take these numbers now and put them in. So those are the numbers I'm going to put on x now. Those are their uncertainties. Let's put them both in log. I just copied and paste, command V, control V rather. All right, and there's, you know, nothing new is happening yet. So first, you can do either one of these things first. Let's do this first. Big so we can see what we're doing. All right, this is the fun part. Let's take this fit off. I don't want that. I'm going to change what's on X. And in Logger Pro, you can toggle what's on any axis by just clicking it one time, single click, left click on the X axis where it says time is what I'm. It gives me all these options. I can put any of these things that I want on X. Now I could like graph displacement versus displacement if I really wanted. That would be, doesn't do much for me, but you know, you can graph anything versus anything. So I want to change my x to time squared. That's how the linearization rules work. Graphing y versus y versus x to the b. And b is the, you know, rounded power that I think is actually happening. Okay, so I got displacement versus time squared, and I'm going to auto scale. Oh, looks like we can straight line happening. Zoom out. That's looking pretty good to me, except I don't have any error bars on my new X stuff yet. I got to do that. All right, so here's how you do it again if you have different sized error bars, which we do for almost always when we linearize. I got to tell Logger Pro to use that column for uncertainty. So I'm going to column options for times squared. I like to just double click the top of the column. I get to the column options, and then I go to options, and then I go to error bar calculations. And then I say, use column. I'm going to tell it, hey, for these numbers, for the times squared numbers, use the column of times squared uncertainty. That's what I named it. Right. So you call, you say, hey, use this column for the size of the error bars. I'm going to say done. All right. So I've got me some horizontal error bars now on here because I told Logger Pro what to do with this. And now I'm going to want to present this graph. And I did this thing because now my data is linearized. I can put a straight line and I get a very nice straight line that goes through all of this data. All right. This was like, you know, especially good linearized data, it's not always going to necessarily look this good, but same rules. If a straight line pretty much goes through error bars, you know, you can justify this. All right, so now that I have a straight line, guess what? You want to do all the fun graph stuff that we do. Like, I'm going to put some min-max lines on here, so I'm going to choose another linear fit and do all that stuff. All right, and I want to do one last check. I got displacement versus time squared. I want to make sure this is updated everywhere, so I also am going to have to change my title. So I'll just double click up here, or you can like right click and go to graph options. But I do want to make sure everything reflects what my new, you know, stuff happening is. Go superscript, go displacement versus time squared. That'll do it. I think I'm covered. All right, so let's just do our thing now. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, nice and big so I can really see. That's good. I'm probably fix this guy up a little bit, but good enough for example. Let me shrink it down because, of course, I do this every time, so it looks nice. Port. All right, so, you know, clean it up, make it look good, make sure everything is, like, readable. Nothing's blocking anything important. And I'm going to copy paste it in. Let's go back to our document. I have this table now, and let's say, you know, here you say, basically, now I graphed it. Here comes, here's this table now. Here it is below on a graph. Show the graph. Uh-oh, I screwed up. This is graph one, so you do want to keep track. You know, in graph two below. That's why we label these, right? Now we're getting to the fun part. We have like multiple tables and multiple graphs, and especially because you're going to be talking about them in a lab report, you want to number them. Yeah, so you can call them out because you always call them out. You never just drop something in and don't talk about it in text, or it might as well not be kind of the idea. All right, so there's my new graph. There's my linearized graph. I've linearized my data. I took a graph that looked like this, used the B number to decide what to do to my X values, and I graphed Y versus my new X values to get a nice straight line with min-max lines, and now we'll proceed as normal, except I got to remember when I talk about it, like in this one, I would probably say displacement is directly proportional to time squared, right? Or displacement depends on T squared, squared relationship, something like that. All right, so that's how, you know, some more Logger Pro graph stuff of how you'll deal with linearization. So enjoy, have fun.